So, have you spoken, okay? So first of all, I am not the same Dmitry as you, so Mudrika is a German salon, so I am Dmitry Popovko, who is working on lifestyle performance and source storage. So I have been working on it for a long time, but mostly for fun, a few years ago, so I started to do it full time. And well, it's really amazing. So you may find all my materials and benchmark report and so on my website. So today I will speak to you about performance schema. So there are some examples, so you may play it yourself. And finally, this talk is about, like I would like if somebody tell me the story for the first time. So in fact, the main question of why performance schema was in under the MySQL and so on. So the problem coming from a long time, and it was very hard to find the truth when we have to fight with internals. On the second part, what happens in that? So in the past, on MySQL, there was a lot of improvements made, which looks correct, but you don't have any performance problem. So there was many changes rejected just because instrumentation was wrong and there was no way to understand what happens inside. So performance schema was invented to instrument all levels of MySQL, averaging whatever happens inside, and to see what you have inside of MySQL, understand how your query is going, where you spend your time, and so on. So who already uses performance? So, you probably saw that sometimes people say that it's too complicated. So you may choose any images you want, and it will look, they will say it's hard to use, and even not elegant things, and it's well. But the point is not really hard, it's loose. So if you, coming from you riding a bike, well, in your life, so if somebody will say that the bike is like that, so probably you will say, well, I will never try it. But in fact, it's so simple, you know. It's exactly the same. So performance schema, since MySQL 5.6, started, so it's enabled by default. So you have nothing to do, just you start MySQL, and you already have some instrumentations enabled. So by default, you have these key features. So we have instrument file I/O, table I/O, query dynamics. So these are just main points around. So any other instrumentation may enable dynamically, except mutexes. So the problem with mutexes is an internal lux, then it will be initialized when you start your MySQL instrument. So that's why it cannot be done later, because all mutexes happen in the beginning. So you cannot enable it dynamically, because they will pass it. That's the only one. All other channels will be repeated again. You know, when you open close the table, so you will start the simulation again. So, if you want to use mutex implementation, you want to look in the tunnel, just keep in mind when you have to enable it from the beginning. So, just say synchronization channel swarm, and it will be okay. Everything else you can do dynamically. And from the beginning, so you have key information to understand what happens in your database. So you can see which files are most used, which tables are most used, and which SQL queries are most problematic for you. So if you have failed and you have some unexpected overhead or something else, so at any time you may disable everything, and you can be sure it will never be done once you do something. So it's just straightforward, you have nothing to do. Now let's see what, once you start MySQL and you enable performance schema, what happens next. So first, we are searching up just to see, because all this information uses some part of memory. And it's related about the maximum number of connections you will configure in the MySQL. So we can see how many memory use, and we can see how many errors we will be able to catch. But well, by default, we will mostly not. To see what happens. And keep in mind So stride instrumentation is always enabled, and you can see what happens inside. You can see what your stride instrumentations are doing. And it's the only way for today, for example, to not lock the whole servo when you look inside. So you know the classic common source processes. So processes do excessive global lock in your instance, so all your work is blocked when you will show the output of what happens inside. So people who monitor our micro server with show processes blocked all the body every time it's blocked. So sometimes I see the people do it every second, but every second you block your instance. So then you say there is no problem, there is a problem. And use one CPU core. So now let's see what happens inside. So this is our thread. And remember I told you we have tables, files, and projects. So let's get a look on file. So just you go to performance schema-based database in G, so you have name of the database, you go inside and you do show tables, which maybe the file. And you have a list of tables. Okay. So just discover step by step each table and you see without doing anything you have information for this step. So if you will look in summary by MA, you will see the main tables that we have related to the file, and you can see all the types of tables, how many writes, how many reads you have by M. So you can see what happens for this. So for example, in this example, you can see that it's mainly MyExam key files are used. Okay? Then, once you know that key files are used, you can go and see by instance. So you just look in the table with something like that. So in fact, when you look on the MD of performance schema, nothing can be more simple than that. So everything is stable, you just do query inside and you have all the information. So by instance, you can see which file is most used in your database. And then just it once, and it's dynamic, so it changes all the time. Then next, let's see table reader. So it's the same way. So you can see, so you will have summary by table, by M and so on. And then, let's see on the lock weights by table. So you will see what time you spend on the locks. And it's just real time. So you remember, we did not configure anything. Just by default, you start your Microsoft S6 or 5.6 derivative. And you have all this information. More detailed. And when you will look inside, so on every table you have time for every iteration. So you can have time for read, for write, and some instrumentation for the detailed for exactly the iterations you have. For example, for IO weights, you will see which exactly comments you are doing on your table. So table IO instrumentation is probably the most sensible because it's going on the very low level. So if your table is all in memory, so you may see some regressions here when you do access to your table because of every read from memory, so you have additional instructions. So you may expect 10-20% sometimes regression here. So if everything is all in memory, so you don't need to investigate table IO. But if you read from the disk, then it will be very interesting. The same by index, so you can see which index used. So here you see there is no name of index, and you know that your table is not using index at all. So you may look which query you are running inside. So let's see on the query now. This is all about statement related again, so we just show the table list. And we have digest inside. So digest is every query you are running will be remastered, so it will be put in universal format. So you can see the digest ID, and you can get the query text from the transportation inside. So what can we see inside? So you have time span of the clearing interval. So when you look on details, you may see by every query, so what happens if I have how many times it was executed, how many rows it's another, did you use indexes or not? So, for example, this simple query, so just to see the number of rows per table, so you can get this query in the query diagram and then look inside of details about this query. And you can see it once. Then we have instead of 30 rows, that there are 25,000 rows examined. So for sure we don't use index in time and so on, and probably we can improve this. And if every time there is no index use. So without doing anything, just query your database and have data about what happens in your database. And let me speak you a few minutes about the most fun stuff for me, analyzing performance. So my main problem is about what happens in Thanos. So it's all about weights. So we have a lot of weights, Evan, and the world. My preference is Evan inside. So Evan which maybe blocks the data weight, blocks the data function, then by understanding the workflow and what happens in the gene, in the MySQL layer and so on, you may understand what is loading. So, it's just simple query. So keep in mind when by default, time is measured in performance in a feature set. So it's zero, in one number, so you have to divide it to obtain seconds time. So very easily you can see where most time is spent, what you're waiting for. So you see when you're waiting for data files, so you're always waiting, the wait time is on IO level, so you are less on more like this. But you need to have other times on other logs, which are loading from higher level performance. So well, I use my own tools for one tool I'm using for my Monitor and do performance analysis of system is called Nista. So I'm developing it for more than 15 years now. So and it has a script inside which is showing you the top events all the time. And well, it's very easy to integrate. So when you don't look on numbers, usually just have such kind of graphs. So if you saw my site, benchmark reports and explanation of performance problems, it's probably something like that. So you can see number of events and why time spent on the grid. So the problem you see is in the past, there was many monitoring features in MySQL, but we always report the number of events. The most important was which came with performance schema, then we have time spent inside. Because it's exactly time spent in show rules and you really lose here. Even the number of errors you have. So, just a few examples for you about weight analysis. So, first one is about lock open. So, lock open intentionally was from a long day, it was here from the beginning of MySQL. And finally fix it in MySQL Web 6. So before when we have when you see lock open going up in debugger, in profiler, whatever. So you may just increase the table open cache and well you will get it. The problem is then once even you create it then it will be not enough. And that's why 5.6 is our passing in performance MySQL 5.5. So in MySQL 5.6 we added the cache instance and you will see why. So usually what you see, so if just your table open cache is small, so just two workloads. One on the left side has a problem and another one has no problem.
Four,
Exactly. So you have a number of users which increase, and then you have a drop. On the right side, you have a right number of people open cache, and you don't have it before. So how you can see it? So in 5.6, now we have new status variables which is related to table open cache. And when you see overflow in this status, so you will take on see why you have a problem. And in performance schema, you have log table cache table. When you see this, the way it's growing up, you know, so you know you have a problem. But the problem is that even if you increase your table open cache, it will still persist. Because well, in 5.6, we push much more far performance schema. And if your log table cache element was in the top element, when you will increase number of instances, you will still gain more in performance. So this helps you to understand why you will win or not win. So once you understand which kind of protection you can inside of this cache. Well, the most speculative probably will be this one. So I don't know if you follow the elements, so in MySQL 5.7, so we announced that during the MySQL panic. So we outpassed the limit, so we reach at 500,000 queries per second of MySQL 5.7. So you see the red line is MySQL 5.7, and everything on bottom is MySQL 5.6, Persona 5.6, MariaDB, and so on. So you see the difference how it's big. But this difference we obtain if we use several tables, which is normal for database. You usually don't have just one table. So we were happy with this result, but well, even there is a bug, we push it anyway. But there was one problem. Then when we use one table, so we don't outpass even 200. And we are worse than 5.6. So the question was why? So all the improvement, everything looks good. The problem is that we improved transaction management in MySQL 5.7, and this increased a lot in deal locking. So in deal locking was done in many sounds, in many ways, and today we have a solution in MySQL 5.7 which improved in deal locking. And again, this improvement did not show any good results. So first graph you can see it's in DL log. The second one we fix it in DL, but we still don't have big performance increase because we hit another log, it will be thread log. And once we fix thread log, we have several graphs, so we have twice better performance than usual. And the fourth graph, so the last one, so when we completely remove MDL and thread log from the code, and you can see the fixes are really good, so we have exactly the same performance. So this will come with MySQL 5.7, and it's because of performance schema we able to take on the same. So before it was all problems were on InnoDB or MariaDB. Now we move it to have problems on MySQL in this old code. Once it's fixed, so we will be back to InnoDB and MariaDB problems. So this is intro, so it's just to give you a minute to start and discover, because the performance schema is a real gold mine to discover everything that's happening inside. This is one example, so just one insert query, and you can understand every place in MySQL you spend your time. So well, this is just one of example which we will cover during the next MySQL Tech Day in Paris. So you are all welcome. So Frederick knows the role exactly from Brussels. So this is a detailed description about performance schema, all the stuff you have inside. So you can, of course, you cannot discover it all the time. So you need to progress, you need to try, and you need to work with, you know, only by your hands people can. And once you will have all this happening, yes, everything will be clear in your life. So, well, of course, there is no free lunch, so instrumentation cannot be free. So if you have, if you add instrumentation code, of course, you add some overhead. So well, what we are saying that we are trying to do it less than 10 cars. So usually it was 5. So when we started to enable performance team and by default it was 6, it was 5 cars. But during 1 year we improved it again, myself at 6, and then it started to be 10 cars. So it depends on workload, it depends on what you are doing, it depends on what instrumentation you enable. So what we ask them, if you see any workload which is give you overhead bigger than 10,000, please report us and we'll say that this is slightly back and we'll try to fix it. So there is a lot of report maintenance around, so Patoma schema will be everywhere. So do not forget about MySphere Enterprise Monitor. So it's created now the performance scheme and have a lot of stuff inside. We show you various features, statistics which happens inside. And we discover a lot of stuff just by using this tool. So for well, it's enterprise tool, so it's not free, but you can buy it if you like it, so I don't know if you think. If you're ready to pay your phone, you buy a tool which you can use all the time. And you have other stuff which is really good. So there are a lot of scripts around. So PS Helper from Mapleads is very popular to simplify your usage of performance team. And OpenMap will come in our medical presentation. Invite you to say it more. And I don't know if you saw the MySQL Workbench came with countries in betas, version 2.1. And we have graphical interface with only your performance schema to enable graphically which kind of instrumentation was on what. And we have PS Helper integrated inside, so you can get reports for it inside. So just download and try it. So you will discover a lot of stuff. And well, just a few words about this stuff. So it's also we download, it's ZPL free. So we can all information about MySQL, so we can monitor system and so on. So it's web-based and it's even more to MySQL. I'm done. So you can find all this information on my site and you have all reports, benchmark logs and so on. Use MySQL performance.